Welcome back to another video, and today is going to be super exciting because I'm doing the childhood writing tag, and I was tagged by author Justin J, author of The Other Side, and I'm doing a Fairy Kei Get Ready With Me. And I don't really talk a lot about Fairy Kei on this channel, so I'm super excited, and I'm super excited for you guys to see me go through this transformation. So let's go. So the first question is, when and why did you start writing? And this is a super cliched answer, but I have been writing ever since I can remember. Like, as soon as I learned how to write, I started writing stories. And I liked when my mom read me bedtime stories, but it wasn't very long until I started reading the stories on my own. And then I just consumed books, and I was like, you know what? I love books so much that I'm gonna just start writing my own. So I want to say either kindergarten or first grade is when I started like writing stories. I used whatever I could find, like notebook paper, construction paper, and then as the book binding, I would use, you know, hair clips, rubber bands, whatever would make it look like a book. And I would, you know, write using like pen, pencil, marker, crayon. So, yeah. And I used to draw a lot too, so I did my own illustrations. So the next one is, what is the first story that you remember writing? Honestly, I'm not sure. The first story I remember writing, like on a computer though, I was in third grade. Before that, it was all like handwritten. But then in third grade, we had to like type. I guess we were learning how to type, and so we had to type a story. So that's what I did. I typed a story, and it was about a girl named Janae or whatever. I don't know why I chose that name, but it was about her. She moved to a new town, and she met this guy, and he was really scary. I think he said something really mean to her. And she ran away. He felt bad, and he apologized. And then they got married, I guess. That was that was the story. All right, so the third question is, what was the first full project you finished, and when, if you have finished one? Well, I mean, arguably, that first one, the one I just told you guys about, that one, but there's also my very first like actual manuscript that I wrote when I was 15, the one that I did a drunk reading of. There's that one, and even before then I wrote all kinds of stories, so it was really hard because I finished a lot of stories. I'm not really sure what's meant here by like project. Like my first manuscript, like actual novel manuscript, I was 15. And that was The Academy. It was like a horror gothic novel. My first published novel was in 2015, and that was called The Adventures and Shenanigans of Bastian Falco, and it was a fantasy adventure. Okay, so I'm doing half blue, half purple, and I know it looks really silly right now, but there is a method to my madness. So the next one is, what genre did you most enjoy writing as a child, and has that changed over time? What was it? Yes, has it changed over time? And, I mean, not really. As a child, I liked all kinds of fantasy, and blue, purple, and I'm gonna blend these in. But I was really, really like fascinated by elves and fairies, which has not really changed at all, and unicorns, which definitely has not changed. So I tended to write more fantasy, And then I became a teenager and I started writing more about vampires. And this was not because of Twilight. Honestly, I just really liked vampires. And then someone on a forum said, "Wow, your story really sounds like Twilight." And I was like, "What's Twilight?" Also, I read Twilight and then I took that as an insult because holy shit. And also, my story was nothing like Twilight. My heroine was a vampire slayer, so. My preteen, middle school, junior high, whatever you want to call it, those years, I was really into anime and manga, so. And this is a time when I actually still liked to draw. So I did a lot of manga stuff, so a lot of like shonen and magical girl stuff, which also hasn't changed because literally when I write anime inspired or manga inspired things, it's literally always magical girl or shonen. Do you remember the first negative feedback you got on the story? Maybe not the first negative feedback. I mean, people never really said anything like, you know, that was really that bad about my stuff until I was in college and I went to my second creative writing workshop. I mean, in the first creative writing workshop, obviously I got like critiques that helped me. It wasn't until my second creative writing workshop where my professor actually tore me a new one. I wrote, this was the fantasy horror that I wrote after the drunk reading one. And I read a part from it. She tore me a new one in front of the entire class. And I just kind of wanted to die. she said I was writing like castles in the sky. So like a fantastical world with no foundation in like real life. And a bunch of the stuff was like unrealistic or something. Like a trap door in a school in a wing that was no longer used and it was in the ceiling and you went up there and there was another room. She was like, "That would never happen." I don't know if I skipped class the next day because I never skipped class, and I think I skipped class the next day because I was so heartbroken. All of that pain resulted in maybe like inarguably one of the best revisions of my life. Like I revised the hell out of that story, so much so that when she read it, she raved about it to the rest of the class, and she told them to read it as an example. And so, yeah, triumph. Okay, so this glittery stuff, you can't really see it, but it's from Surreal Makeup, and I think this specific color is called Princess Bride, which, I mean, duh, why would I not buy makeup called Princess Bride? But it's like a silvery blue purple, and I use it to blend the purple and the blue together so it doesn't look like this block of blue and this block of purple. It is so pretty, and I put it like in the middle and I like blend it in a bit. It's kind of hard, like Camera, mirror. So the next one is, who's your favorite character that you wrote as a kid? As like a child, probably a little older child, before preteen years, I'd say my vampire slayer character, even though I can't remember her name, I can't really remember the plot either. Then when I became like a preteen, when I was making like manga, I was literally drawing manga, those characters, They were like, one of them was like an elf. I think it was like half elf, half human. And he had like a red ponytail, so you can totally tell that I was inspired by like Rurouni Kenshin and like Kurama from Yu Yu Hakusho. The next one is share some old writing of yours. Can I do, actually, this works. Maybe I don't have to go to the, no, actually wait, no, yes, I have to go to the mirror actually, because I missed. You see this like little blue, this little purple here? I missed by the eyeliner. That's not gonna fly. But if you want to know what some of my old writing looked like, remember when I told you about that manuscript I wrote when I was 15? I did a drunk reading of the first chapter. I mean, one, because yeah, it would be funny, but two, you kind of have to be drunk to read it because it's so bad. I'll probably put like a card up here somewhere, but check it out. What parts of your writing have improved since then? And everything. Like, but to be more specific, like obviously craft, dialogue, everything, character description development, but also I've learned to be more inclusive. I've learned to ground even my most fantastical science fiction and fantasy stories in reality somehow. I love taking elements from real life, you know, and making them ultra recognizable in a largely unrecognizable world, if that makes sense. Does that make sense? I don't think that makes me unique though. I think that's, especially with science fiction, I think that's what science fiction is supposed to be. You can't
really tell, but I put some of that surreal makeup glitter over top my blush. Maybe when I start taking selfies, you'll be able to see what it looks like. I also put some under here to replace some of the stuff I... It looks super goofy in this lighting. I swear it doesn't look this bad.
Put on jewels! Are there any parts of your writing that have not changed much? And honestly, I mean, yeah, I still write fantasy. Now I've added that I write sci-fi. I don't really write horror or gothic literature anymore, or anything like that. It's mostly fantasy, sci-fi. When I was in college, I wrote literary fiction because that's what we were supposed to write. That's what everybody wanted us to write. And then that's what we were told, that you need to write literary fiction in order to get into a good school, a good MFA program. So there's that. I haven't written anything literary in a while, but if I ever want to teach creative writing at the college level, which is my ticket to getting out of teaching comp at the college level, which is what I'm doing now, then I would have to get my MFA.
It's been so long since I've done face jewels, wow.
Okay, so oof, you guys are going to witness the true power of 4C hair, which comes straight out of Mother Africa, like on the scale of like 1A all the way to 4C, it's at the very end. So the last question is, if you could tell your childhood self one thing, what would it be? And like in terms of writing, my childhood self, just keep writing, honestly. And I mean, I was gonna do that anyway, but and to like my preteen self, like this is when I started experimenting with, you know, putting people of color into my stories. And so I would say, don't let people, you know, discourage you from doing that. like when I was drawing manga and one of my characters was brown. And one of my friends was like, why is she brown? Like anime characters have white skin. Why does she look like that, right? And at the same token, like even when I did adhere to like what manga characters really look like I was drawing like, you know, magical girls. So obviously inspired by Sailor Moon. And then one of my black classmates came up to me and she was like, why are all your characters white? And I was like, they're not white, they're Japanese. But I can understand why she would ask that, because like Sailor Moon is supposed to be Japanese. But Usagi has blonde hair and blue eyes. So, and none of the Sailor Scouts are brown. So I don't know, I guess I just could not win. There was always someone telling me my characters should be white and my characters should be brown. And honestly, I didn't realize at the time that I was craving representation. I was just trying to make characters who looked like me, but at the same time, the fact that there were never any characters who looked like me made me think that we kind of didn't belong in fantasy, sci-fi, anime, manga. It wasn't until I was quite a bit older that I realized, no, yeah, we definitely should be in anime, manga, and fantasy and sci-fi. Like, black people read these things, we watch these things, and like, anime is not something that's, you know, super niche anymore. It's mainstream. There are seasons. This is not the era of like classical anime where everybody's pretty much talking about the same anime and it's largely, you know, a very mystical Japanese thing. Everybody knows about anime now. And people in Japan, the people who are creating these things, they know that we exist. They know that they have large black and brown audiences. So every once in a while, you know, you see, you know, a more diverse cast in anime. But like, it's a start. It's a start. And I don't know, this was kind of a rambling thing, but I would just like my middle school self to know that, you know, if I want a character to be Japanese, they can be Japanese. If I wanted them to be black or brown, then they can be black or brown. Like, don't let people tell you what color your character should be. And I guess this would also go for like any sort of marginalized group, honestly, because representation does not only mean people of color. It covers a wide range of groups, which I have only begun to explore in my adulthood. Call for representation is perpetual and ubiquitous. I'm not trying to tell anyone, you know, you should add more people of color in your story. Like, I'm not the representation police. You can write whatever you want to write. I, for one, will be more inclined to play video games or read stories or watch anything fantasy or sci-fi related if there are black women, like black people, people of color, especially black women, because people usually think of us the least. So I will watch something like Cannon Busters or Carolyn Tuesday over anything, you know, over most other anime, for example, because that's just what I want to see right now. Like, I haven't read a lot of fantasy lately because I'm just like, this is cool, this is great, but can I get more people who look like me? So I'm actively seeking that out rather than telling people what they should. So I just felt like I needed to clear that up because I don't want people saying, oh, you don't want people telling you what to write, but you tell other people what to write. Just, oh, I wanted to clear that up. Reason number 2,556 as to why I just wear my afro most days. I hate parting my hair. It's such a battle. Part's not even straight. All this time I've only got half of it parted. This is gonna be a while. Alright, so on to what I'm gonna wear. Okay, so I love these stockings from Holly Tea Time. Aren't they gorgeous?
So now it's time to accessorize. Alright, so these are rings on one hand, and these are rings on the other. This bow is from Choco Mint, and this yellow and white one is also from Choco Mint. And this pink and white one with spoons on it matches this pink and white one with teapots on it. And then this is the whole outfit. This I just made from, like, I had these beads from something, and I already had this stuffed animal. So I made a necklace out of it, and this shirt is the one I talked about in the last video, my previous video, in my kawaii haul. This necklace I got from a thrift store years and years ago. This head bow is angelic pretty. It matches my aquarium carnival, JSK. And then just some flower and stuff. Cute little bunny earrings. Let's see, my book bag has, my purse has Marie from Aristocats. And there's like a little pusheen. It's actually the unicorn pusheen. You can get a better look of everything this way. Unicorn pusheen, and then this magical girl first aid kit from Poofythel. And I actually have stuff in here for a first aid kit. It is my first aid kit. Thank you everyone for listening to my childhood writing tag and also watching this fairy cage transformation. Just, gosh, I've been so lazy with accessories recently. I'm just like, no, look at all these rings. But yeah, likes and subscribes help me out quite a lot. Super Ninja shout out to Casian Holly and LCT Comics. And I'll see you guys next time. Bye!